Okay, and then when we look in this our car's headlight lamp back area, we have to find first this headlight height control motor, and it is easy to see because that one is in headlight bulb, and here is also bulb, but one of these areas, when we open all of these parts in that way, we can see, okay, this is not motor. And then how about in here? Is this maybe motor? No, there is long bulb. And then when we check all of these positions, finally we can see that there is one part where goes these electric cables, and this is this motor. And this motor is easy to replace so that we only take good grip in here, and then we rotate in that way, and carefully we pull out. And then we have to look in this inner area, and there is this joint. And let's go to look closer. Okay, and then if we have any issues in this our headlight movement, normally the thing is that one. And we need to only take our headlight lamp away, and then when we look in that down area, back area, there is one part what is little bit different than these bulbs what are in here. It looks different, and this part goes to that hole in here. And now I have to move this my inner this light in that area that I can see this inner joint. And that white joint belongs in here. An idea is to only press in here down, little bit force, in that way, look. And now it goes deeper, it takes little bit time, and now it clicks inner, and then I need to only rotate that in back in here. And now this headlight lamp, height motor, it has been installed back. Excellent. Okay, and there is really this joint, and now I have to only keep, I have to carefully pull out this my motor, and I have to keep in good position in this body, this headlight console body, and then I carefully pull out that in this up position, soon it opens in that way. And now this motor is free, and this is this connection part, and that's way we can take this motor away, and we need to only purchase this new part, or then we can maybe repair that hacked motor. And next I open this motor, and we can see that if there is anything what we can repair. And you might think that where you can purchase these motors, there's internet shopping place like ebay.com and amazon.com where we can find these used parts and also in new parts. Okay, but then let's go to look that inner area, how this headlight control works. And let's go to look this inner area next. Okay, and firstly I have to be some workbench where I install this my motor, and there's idea that these clips and those joints, connectors, they are possible to open. And that's I have to install that part in this way that I can open this part. And now I believe that it is maybe better to install in this position this part, because There is chance to open that better. Let's look at how it happens. I install that carefully in here. An idea is to open these clips in here. Now I press that little bit, not too much force, because otherwise these plastic parts can damage. Okay, and now when I start to open this joint, it is good to take flathead screwdriver, and there are those small parts what I can open in here. And let's go to look that closer, and I will show that idea. Okay, and now we can see this area closer, and idea is to little bit use that my flathead screwdriver and little bit bend that, and then same time move that little bit up, and then there is also some another parts and like little bit bend, and we can let this one screwdriver in that kind of position in all of those locking joints, and let's go to do that. Okay, and now I have many of these screwdrivers, and I install in all of these areas this my flathead screwdriver in here in that way, and then I have second joint in here in that area, and I install also in here my next. Okay, and now one of those my screwdrivers moves, and then I can start to carefully to open this my upper area. There is in that area I install this one, and there is one joint, and then in that area in here down, this is final one. Okay, and now I have installed these my screwdrivers in all of these areas, and now we can see that I have installed in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 flathead screwdrivers in here, and now I believe that this upper area, it is possible to open. And let's look when I move that carefully up that way, and it opens really nicely. Yes, a little bit movement, and this part opens just greatly. Excellent. And then we can go to look inside what we can see in there in that area. Excellent. Okay, and now when we look in their inner area, we can see that in that area there are those connector that electricity goes through in that area, and then in that part there is this part's position, and this part's movement, this white bar, this is the thing what makes this movement happens. And now there is idea to check that how much this inner part moves in here. Now I rotate that because this rotation should move. Yes, now it really moves. Now we can see that now this position, it's like starting position. Look that white area in here. And then when I move that shaft and axle, and now when I move that white axle, it is like electric motor in there inside, what we look soon. This area, that white nut and this ball, white ball, it starts to move. Look, now this ball is just behind of that wheel in here, that they are in same position. But then when I move that shaft in here, look, now it starts to move. And this is like position 1, and then there is position 2, and then final part is now it's closed. This is position number 3. Okay, and that means that in this way, this our Hecht lamp, Hecht control works, and then when we install switch to 0, this automatically moves back. Okay, and in that way, we can see that in this my Hecht motor, it works well, and that's we have to also inspect this inner area, that how this motor works, and is this okay or not, and let's go to look inner area next. Okay, and now when we look in this inner area, we have to now take more parts away in here, and now there is risk that when I start to open these parts always, that they are old and these parts can damage. But if we are lucky and we work carefully with this small flathead screwdriver, we can see more these, that is this my motor okay or not, and now it opens nicely, excellent. And in here, really, there is electric motor in here, excellent. And then we can test that is this my motor okay or bad, and we can replace that motor if it is broken. Like in that my case, this motor is possible to take out in that way, and in carefully when I move these metallic pins away in here, in that way, now motor is free. And we can purchase this new motor, and there is this type in here from eBay or Amazon.com. And this is electric motor, two pins in here, and standard motor. And then we can also check in this inner area that how this my wheels works in here. Now when I rotate that, we can see that this part moves, and we can also check that what happens when this motor is running. Because when motor is running, there is this shaft what takes contact in here, and when I move that, then this my axle goes up and down. Okay, and in that way, my friend, you can also replace and repair this height control motor. And my friend, thank you for watching, and thumbs up if you liked the video, and see you in next video.